Hi, George here. Today we're going to be working on this horse picture and improving the background quite a bit and make it look like that. I'll be demonstrating this in Photoshop Elements 2023. And if you want to learn more about my complete training for Photoshop Elements 2023, take a look at the link right down there at the top of the description. Okay, first thing I'll do is just to get rid of all of these extra layers in here. Get this back to just the background layer. There we go. There's the original image. Now I'll be doing this in two steps. One is fixing the background, and the second one is fixing the foreground subject. So to make that so we can balance that out, I want to make a new layer with just the foreground subject, that horse, on that layer. So we'll start off by going up here where it says background on the layers, right-click, and duplicate layer. Choose OK. Now on this layer, we'll go up here to select and come down to subject, and that should select just that horse for us. And there we go, it looks pretty good. A couple little problems in here. We can clean those up. I'm just going to grab any of our selection tools, that's fine. That gives us the refined edge down here. And I'll set the feathering here to 0 and click on refine edge. There we go. You can see there's the brush size. It's kind of small. I'll bring that up a bit, maybe up to 50. That's better. Not too large. I like working with this overlay, pinkish reddish color. It's just easy to see where I'm working at. And I'll leave everything else at the defaults. Now just brush over any of the little spots like this where it looks like it wasn't quite catching the full image. I see some of that light blue sky showing through. And that's mostly just along the edges of the hair. Everything else looked pretty good. Let's get this out of the way and right down here. And I'll come right along that as well. There we go. Now there's one more spot right down here that was missed. Let's see if I can get that taken care of. There it is. That's fixed also. Okay, so I've never refined the edge. I think we're okay. We can double check this. I'm just going to set this 4 on white and see. And that looks good. I think we have all of our edges in there real nice. So that's fine. Back to overlay and OK. There's our selection. Now go up here and click on the layer mask button. Makes a layer mask of just the horse if I hide the background. There we go. There's just the horse in the foreground. So that's nice. That gives us that horse on its own separate layer, which we'll be using later on. Okay, now come back to the background. And for this, we're going to be going over to the guided edits right here. Click on guided. And we're in special edits. And go over here, perfect landscape, and we use this to give us a new sky in the background. And I'll start with removing haze. This is going to go in and just increase our contrast a little bit, and that often helps. There we go. I'm mostly looking at the tree line back here. I think that's fine. We can now come down and add in a new sky right here. Once you click on one of these new skies elements, we'll go in and make a mask and all that kind of stuff for us. So start with the first one, and we'll see how this goes. Now, whenever you're changing a sky like this, it's good to go with something that's similar in coloration to the one that you already have. That's going to hide any problems in there. Now that looks nice, but it's not what I want. What I chose was here, one called Blue 4. Let this go ahead and show. There we go. I think that's a really good choice. There's a lot of skies to choose from here. And in Elements 2023, they've added in quite a few additional sky photos. The only thing you don't want to do is go totally different. Let's just do something strange like this night sky right here. Because often this will require some additional work. Notice we have kind of a halo around the edge in here and a bit of a halo down there on the landscape. So it takes some more work for this to work out. And of course, he's lit for daytime and not nighttime. So you really want to be doing something which is similar to the same coloration and similar to the same time of day for the best effect. And again, that's our blue sky right here. And there we go. Okay, I'll scroll down a little bit. We have some more options. We can adjust our opacity and brightness. I think that's fine. We can auto match color tone. We'll give that a shot. Sometimes that helps. And it's lighting up the horse and lighting up the trees. I don't care about that. I'll leave those as is. We'll leave that off. Everything else is fine. So come down and click on the next button right here, and then choose in expert to go back over into expert mode. Okay, so far so good. We can now work on the horse part of this photo. If you're enjoying this video, make sure you hit that like button, click on subscribe, and click on that bell icon for notifications of my new videos. Okay, let's come down here. This is the layer with just the horse on it. I'll pull this clear up to the very top. There we go, at the top. We now have our new horse here in front of the new background. And this allows us to make adjustments on just the horse without touching or hurting the background. So let's go up to layer, come down to new adjustment layer and levels. That's all we're going to be needing in here. Where it says use previous layer, check that, choose OK. I want to increase the contrast just a little bit and tweak our midtones. So for the contrast, you pull the black slider and the white slider in towards the middle. So just a little bit on the black, just a little bit on the white. That increases the contrast. And then grab the middle one to adjust your midtones, and then find a nice balance point. I don't want to go too far to the left on this because it begins to wash out that nice red color in here. You see that? So just a little bit of that to the left of one, maybe 1.10 is pretty nice. And then I can adjust the dark parts here, the darkness, looking in this area of the horse here in the shadows. And I can judge from that. I don't want to go clear to the left because I'm losing some of my contrast. I want just a little bit in there, but not so much that I'm losing any real detail. So just a touch like that, and just a little bit in here on the lights. And I think, again, rocking it back and forth right about there looks just about perfect. Close that down. And there we are. Now to compare this to the original, easy to do. Let's just come down here and grab the background layer, right click, make a duplicate of that layer, choose OK, and then grab that, move it to the top. There's the original, let's hide that, and there's our new layer. So original and new layer. And if you like the video, make sure you hit that like button. Don't forget to subscribe and to share. And take a look at my complete training course for Photoshop Elements. I have links for the new course and also links for other courses right down there at the top of the description. And I'll see you next time.